And a model of democratic transformation. It shares many common values with Canada, both democratic, pluralistic, please welcome to the stage for our welcome remarks, the Director General of the Taipei Economic and Cultural Office, Toronto, Ms. Catherine Pichet.
The Honorable Senator, members of the Parliament, members of the Provincial Government, Your Worships, DOCAC, Commissioners, leaders of the community, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, good evening. On behalf of the Taipei Economic and Cultural Office in Toronto, I'd like to extend my warmest welcome and most appreciation to all of you for joining us at tonight's reception in celebrating the 106th National Day of the Republic of China, Taiwan. This past year, our new government, under the leadership of President Tsai Ing-wen, who took office in May 2016, has strived to create a new era of democracy, freedom, prosperity, and security for Taiwan. Early last year, people in Taiwan elected the Republic of China's first female president and completed a smooth transfer of political power in our democratic development. Taiwan is one of the freest democracies in the world. Take the freedom of press as an example. Taiwan ranked second in Asia by Freedom House and first in Asia by Reporters Without Borders in their 2017 index, respectively. The fact that Reporters Without Borders chose Taiwan to establish its first Asia Bureau in July is a testament to our outstanding terms in freedom of expression and information. Economically, our new government's policy to transform our economic structure has already entered its implementation phase. Several projects under the 5+2 Innovative Industries Initiative, for example, the Asian Silicon Valley, the biotech, the green energy, and also the national defense technology, has been put in motion. Our GDP is forecasted to grow higher, and new government's views on strong policy to boost the exchange with the rest of Asia has also borne fruit in the form of a steady increase in trade and tourism. While a new wave of the economic momentum has been created, we are very pleased to see two major significant Canadian investments in Taiwan, both from Ontario. They are the Northern Powers offshore wind project and also a film studio project for Hollywood in Hualien. We welcome initiatives like this with open arms. Nevertheless, among Canadians' major trading partners, Taiwan is the only one that hasn't had an investment deal with the nation. So we hope a bilateral consultation on FIPA, the Foreign Investment Protection and Promotion Agreement, can be launched soon, so that these mutually beneficial relations can be further developed. Moving on to the regional and international aspects, we continuously pledge to maintain a status quo of the peace and stability in cross-strait relations. We always keep our door open for consultations and dialogues in order to create mutual understanding, increase mutual trust. In addition, we reaffirmed our commitment to playing a positive role in international collaboration on cross-border issues of global concern, such as climate change, health, crime, money laundering, to name a few. Early this year, when we were not invited to the WHA, the World Health Assembly, which we have attended for 8 consecutive years, Canada stepped up to render your support to Taiwan. So today, I'd like to take this opportunity to express Taiwan's deep appreciation to many of the Canadian friends, politician friends present today for your great help and your voice of justice. D despite the challenges confronting Taiwan, we continue to uphold our steadfast diplomacy and expand our international engagement. In recent months, Taiwan successfully hosted two very important international events. University Summer Universiade attracted over 10,000 athletes and supporting personnel from over 130 countries. WCIT World Conference on Information Technology, which usually referred to as the Olympics of Global ICT, was attended by over 2,000 IT leaders from more than 80 countries. And during these two events, Canada had a strong presence at Universiade. At the closing ceremony of UDS Universiade, our Canadian team displayed a long banner written in Chinese, Mandarin Chinese, 谢谢你台北, meaning thank you Taipei. This friendly gesture touched many, many people in Taiwan. It is this friendship between our two peoples and the core values shared by us, including democracy, freedom, rule of law, human rights, that bring Taiwan and Canada together. Earlier this week, our University of Toronto students taking part in the Global Taiwan Study Initiative had a great presentation on the various researchers they did in Taiwan, from security and identity, innovation, health insurance, to indigenous women and migrant workers. The richness and the diversity of the topic are beyond imagination. This is such a Taiwan, a dynamic and vigorous Taiwan that we feel so proud of. And this Taiwan, I think, deserve Canada's standing interest. Taiwan and Canada have enjoyed such a cordial friendship for such a long time. And let's work together to promote an even closer and stronger Canada-Taiwan relations. In closing, I would like to wish my country continuous prosperity and success. 我要恭祝中华民国国力昌隆，风调雨顺，希望一个活力的台湾在国际上耀升。 Happy birthday to the Republic of China, Taiwan.
Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, good evening. 徐处长，各位贵宾，各位侨界先进，各位女士、先生，大家晚安。我是杨俊宏，很荣幸在今晚庆祝中华民国106年国庆日的酒会活动中，与加拿大友人及侨界乡亲齐聚一堂，共同为中华民国庆生。 中华民国台湾是一个民主自由的国家，不仅拥有美丽的土地，与亲切善良的人民，在经贸发展的成就更是全球有目共睹。加拿大与台湾都是尊重多元文化，而且共享自由、民主、和平、人权的主流价值。我们侨胞乡亲虽然身处海外， 但无时无刻都非常关心台湾的政经现况，也在侨居地协助政府推动整体外交及侨务工作，并致力促进台加关系更进一步提升。而遍布世界各地的侨民，更是政府布局全球的种子。 把勤恳实干的台湾精神散布到全球，让世界看见台湾。我们相信未来台湾在蔡总统的领导下，就算面对复杂的两岸关系及全球化竞争的挑战，仍能走出国家自己的道路，并完成社会各项转型与改革。多伦多侨学各界侨胞除了表达对政府的支持与向心力之外，也会适时提出建言，并将结合侨界人士的力量，协助政府推动总体外交工作，提升台湾在侨居地的能见度，以及加强台湾与加拿大的实质关系。中华民国台湾在政府与海内外同胞一起努力打造出来的自由民主成果，已具体展现在今日繁华富裕的台湾。相信台湾社会将展现源源不绝的生命力，为弘扬自由、民主、和平、人权的国际主流价值，缔造更多佳绩。最后，谨再次代表全体侨胞祝贺中华民国台湾生日快乐，国运昌隆。同时，并祝各位先生、各位贵宾身体健康、万事如意。谢谢大家，多谢各位。
Thank you very much. Good evening, everyone. Director General, it's always wonderful to enjoy your gracious hospitality on Double Ten Day, marking this year the 106th anniversary of the 10th of October, 1911, the beginning of the Wuchang Uprising. It is my pleasure to bring the greetings of Andrew Scheer, the leader of the Conservative Party of Canada and the official opposition in Parliament. As we celebrate this anniversary and the warm relationship between Canada and Taiwan, we do so aware of a powerful neighbor just across the Formosa Strait who is not very enthusiastic about the Canada-Taiwan relationship. And we pledge to you and to you, Director General, and to your government that we in the official opposition, the Conservative Party of Canada, will continue to encourage our Liberal government to more enthusiastically build on the relationship between Canada and Taiwan. In particular, we encourage the Liberals to more forcefully defend Taiwan's representation at meetings of agencies of the United Nations in Canada, like ICAO, the International Civil Aviation Organization, or IATA, and for journalists who would represent Taiwanese news organizations in covering such United Nations events. Conservatives also strongly favor Taiwanese observer status at other United Nations organizations like the World Health Organization, Interpol, and all other such bodies that Canada is a member. But tonight is for celebration, so bring on the drums, bring on the dance, and let me end by saying, Zhonghua Mingguo,
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, Councilor General. Thank you very much for the invitation to be here again this year for this great celebration. Seems like just the other day that we were here for the 105th celebration, and here we are back doing it again. It seems like the Taiwanese community is partying all the time. So thank you, and thank you very much for including me in some of those parties. On behalf of Pastor Dunn and the PC Caucus, I want to bring greetings to one and all, and congratulations to the 106th anniversary of your great nation and your great republic. I just want to point out one of the things I've heard in my travels, the difference between a birthday and an anniversary is that the birthday that happens, they both start with an event. And the birthday comes every year, whether you do anything about it or not. In fact, you can shoot through the whole thing. Rip Van Winkle did that, and he got the same life in each birthday as the rest. Anniversaries are different. Anniversaries, if you don't work at it, if you don't work hard at it, they will quit. Because they only come as long as you can hold it together. And I think that this year, the case with the and all the years and the anniversaries that have passed between Taiwan and Canada, obviously have worked very well together to keep it going for 106 years. Now, I also want to say, I don't want to make it political, but my job is to make sure that I put a good face on the Conservative Party of Ontario. And this is an election year. It's actually next year, but we're in the last year leading up to an election. So I don't want to put forward any political statements. I want to say congratulations to one and all. And I just want to say that I know I want to, in order to put the best things on, I want to do for everybody in the audience what they like most about politicians. And that's a short speech. Thank you very much for inviting me. And
as well. well. And I'm not sure if Fred Wang is here, but just recently we had an opportunity to open officially Fontana condominiums, which are right in the heart of downtown Markham Center, just literally a 2-minute walk from the Markham Civic Center. It is, without question, an incredible and one of the most outstanding buildings in the city of Markham, and reflects, I think, the quality and the commitment that the Taiwanese have made to Markham, to the GTA, and indeed Canada. Thank you for the great contribution that you made, and thank you for the invitation to celebrate with all of you the 106th anniversary. Thank you.
I think the mayor was going to say something. He said he enjoyed having dinner on the tallest building in the world, on the World Trade Center, 103 building. So I think he'd like to go back down the line. Okay, Frank, you're always welcome. The next time, make sure you take me along. Thank you.
Thank you very much. I'm pretty sure you've heard about all the political speeches you want, so I'll make this very short. Director General, distinguished guests and friends, thank you very much for the invitation to be here for the 106th anniversary of National Day of Taiwan. It is a pleasure to be here and to celebrate with you, because we have, as Canadians, so much to share in common with Taiwan. As mentioned earlier, our belief in peace and prosperity, of this democracy and of hope, and of working together to build a great nation. And it's certainly evident in Taiwan. I was there in the spring, an amazing experience, and on this Thanksgiving weekend in Canada, the things that I'm thankful for aren't just the peace and prosperity in Canada, but in fact the peace and prosperity of our friends around the world. I also wanted to take just this moment to thank the Director General and the staff for the great job they did in hosting or assisting hosting our high school group that went to Taiwan this spring. And I look forward to working with you as we host the group next spring from Taiwan to continue our intercultural exchange and our friendship. Thank you very much, and I wish you the very best and peace and prosperity in now what will soon be your 107th anniversary of being a great nation. Thank you very much.
Good evening, Director General, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of Chief Mark Saunders, I'd like to thank you for the opportunity to be here this evening to extend our congratulations on this 106th National Day of Celebration. The Taiwanese community has been in Canada since the 1970s, and numbers up to around 100,000 today, with many teachings done in the stronger. From early on in those early days, we've always been active participants in the community. And I have no doubt that some of that history is why we have two young Taiwanese born members of the service that are part of the Toronto team, one in 32 Division, one in 52 Division, who is actually here this evening. In addition to that, members of the Taiwanese community also are part of the Chief's Consultative Committee, and have always been working in partnership on initiatives to enhance the city of Toronto. So I want to thank you for your continued work in our community and your genuine and sincere commitment to the city of Toronto. Thanks very much.
Because it's about relationships. And building relationships. With your permission, Director General, I would like to invite a very special person up to the stage with me, Peter. If you can come up. Peter is the police liaison stationed here in Toronto, and he has traveled during his assignment here across the province, building relationships with police services, not just in the city of Toronto, but across the whole country. And so I would get calls from Peter when he's in there. And the reason I invited him up here, my understanding is that he will be returning. His assignment's going to be finished August of next year. And so I won't have an opportunity before he goes home to thank him for building the many, many relationships. When you look across this room, the many different police officers, it's because of his, Peter and his team that has built those relationships. As a token of my appreciation on behalf of police services across the country, this is a very special coin that was minted for Canada 150. And I'd like to present this to you here. Thank you.